Have you seen increasingly larger gluten-free sections at your local store? Why is that? Some kind of fancy new diet? Not quite. Hey guys, Trace here for DNews. For the 1% of the population with celiac disease in the United States, your long nightmare is finally over. The FDA has set standards for gluten-free labeling. Gluten-free standards are now specifying that anything under 20 parts per million is allowed to be considered actually free of that gluten-y devil. Yes, there will be some gluten in stuff labeled gluten-free, but 20 parts per million is like 32 seconds out of a year, or a drop of water in your car's gas tank. It is not much. Having celiac disease is not the same as a food allergy. Food allergies, like with wheat or shellfish, involve the body's antibodies attacking something that they see as an invader. Celiac is an autoimmune disease, so the immune system is attacking the body itself. When a person with celiac disease consumes gluten, their immune system goes on the fritz and starts attacking the villi in the small intestine that are responsible for absorbing nutrients from food. This lack of nutrients, in combination with the immune system attacking its own body, causes a number of negative physiological effects and can even stunt development in children. Gluten is a protein found in wheat, rye, and barley. It's not bad for you, nor is it a product of food processing. Gluten is a Latin word for glue. It's the glue that holds bread together, and it was discovered by monks in the 7th century. If you've eaten gluten-free breads, you've probably missed that chewy texture from regular bread. That's the gluten. It's used in regular foods, but it's also animal feed occasionally, and sometimes added to vegetarian meat to give it protein and consistency. But if it's just that 1% of the US population that has that problem with it, why do people hate on gluten so much? Now, for those of you who are unfamiliar with living gluten-free, there are plenty of resources around the web. But just as an FYI, if you don't need to live that way due to your autoimmune disorder, choosing to do so will not inherently make you healthier. Outside of the 1% of Americans with celiac, as many as 7% of people have a gluten sensitivity, but many others are piling onto this gluten-free bandwagon. Similar to our other videos regarding fad diets, cutting out a food group is a fad, and simply paying more attention to what you're putting into your body will be enough to lose some weight. Americans tend to overeat grains and bread, so a noob trying a gluten-free diet will often immediately cut back on grains. But a gluten-free diet doesn't mean low carb, and it doesn't necessarily mean better. In fact, if done poorly, simply gutting the gluten from your diet can leave people deficient in iron, calcium, B vitamins, and vitamin D, according to the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics. It can also be hard to get enough fiber. The problem with celiac disease is how underdiagnosed it is, and as more people realize they have it, we'll probably see more gluten-free options. But don't think that just because it says science word free that they mean healthy. They just mean safe to eat for those people. What do you think about gluten-free? Have you tried a gluten-free food that you think is better than the gluten-free full version? Share it with us. Start the conversation. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. We'll see you later.